the last day of the Pennsylvania flintlock season, January 15th. It's in the afternoon. I only have a couple hours, if that, to hunt. I'm getting out right now for the first time all flintlock season. Just haven't had the time. I've been wanting to get out to try to find that big buck, and I've just been too busy. My wife had our second child about a month ago, so it's been pretty busy. Just haven't had time to get out. But what I'm using is about 75 grains of 2F Go-X black powder, pillow ticking patched round ball, and it's always seemed to be pretty good for me over the years. This combination, you don't really need 100 grains of powder in your gun, stuff like that, but hoping to just get out real quick, run around, and see if I can find that big buck. That's my whole goal, is just hit a couple spots real quick, see if I can find that big buck, and then after that, I'm done for the year. Then I go to try to find the sheds. I don't even know if he's on the property. This buck seems to be who knows where. I know of one other neighbor about a mile and a half away who has seen him over the past 2 years, and he's bouncing back and forth between our property, their property. But really, he's not really moving too much, but it seems like if he is here, he's in a particular few areas, so that's all I'm hoping. Check those areas, see if he's there. Hopefully I can see him before he sees me, get a shot. That's my goal. So this might be a very quick video, or I don't even know if I'm gonna have a video, but if I see something, you'll be watching this. This is pretty much a speed hunt, a speed skill hunt. You know, people talk, I don't got much that time to hunt. I'm telling you right now, here's the keys. Get to know your property well. Get to hunt the late season. You don't know your property. If you tell me, oh, I know my property, I know where all the bedding and stuff like that is, doesn't matter. I want you to tell me, what do those deer do if you bump them from a certain direction? Where do they go? That's what I mean. You have to know where those deer go if you do bump them. How are you going to get back on them? You're going to take an easy route? You're going to take a long route? So, got to get to know your property. Hunt that late season. Find out where those pressured deer like to go. And then keep sneaking up on them in that late season. Figure out how to get to those bedding areas without them detecting you. And that's the whole key to it. You'll get to learn during pressured deer, or some of the easier deer to hunt. I like pressured deer because they're predictable, especially on my property. I like late season deer hunting because they're all gathered up too. And usually if you see one, you see a bunch. So, got some coyote tracks. So, this is sort of just gonna hurry up, get out there, see if I can find that buck, and that's it. Look at that. I'm not gonna stop. She's right there. That'd be an easy kill. It looks like a fawn. These deer are not moving. Look at that. She's literally 20 yards. There she goes. There's mama. I see mama back there. If I wanted to, 5 minutes into the hunt, I could have a dead doe. But I'm gonna get out here. She's gonna bump the deer if I push her too hard. Start looking down over these benches. I'm changing game plans pretty fast. Whew, this cold air burns the lungs and the nostrils. It's too crunchy in the woods. Listen. So I'm just gonna have to get on the opposite side where I don't think the deer were gonna be. It's probably where they're at, because I gotta find places where it's not crunchy. I'm not finding my deer tracks where there should be deer tracks, and beds where there should be beds. So when all the snow got froze up, it's like a wet snow, it turned to ice, crunchy stuff. Deer have to be on the other side of the hill where the sun's at, so that's where I'm going. I was right. They're up here where the sun's melting the snow. They're in my other food plot. Look like doe. There's two. I spotted another one. Looks like a buck. But I can't tell exactly how big. It's a nice one. I'm gonna have to move in, get a closer look. He's coming out. Definitely not the big one. Okay, I'm gonna leave him go. Keep looking for another one. I got a doe. She's trying to come and investigate. She knows there's something up. Do not tempt me, doe. Do not tempt me. Just stay like that. Do not give me a broadside shot. Stay right there at about 100 yards. And I'm gonna turn around and walk away. That buck is pushing these doe right down to me. Really looks like the one that I passed up on opening day, a rifle. Perfect symmetrical 8-point, good 2-year-old. Letting him go for sure. All right, so I moved to the other side of the property in the logged out section, and right there's my drill camera, and right there is a deer bedded. Thing is, that's where I want to go. I'm just gonna have to be ready in case there's a big buck in there. Okay, it jumped. There's another deer standing up behind that log, and it looks like a doe too. Okay, I'm not messing with that. Just looks like two doe. I'm gonna get. So I'm pulling all my trail cameras too. Right there's a trail camera right there on this tree right here. And as I was coming down in here, it's hard to see down in these shadows, but there's a deer bedded right there, and it jumped up, ran down over. It kind of looked like a doe, only one though. Maybe it was a small buck. Lots of guys are saying that they're finding sheds and deer antlers right now. Whoa, that's a bad sign. Your deer are not in good shape if you're finding deer antlers in January. Those deer should be holding their antlers on a lot longer than that. These deer are all up in this thicket stuff, and they're up all over on the other side where the sun is melting the snow. The snow is real soft and not so crunchy. That's where the deer are. But hey, 1 8-point, I'm almost done with my quick hunt. And I've seen, I actually lost count of how many deer. At least I saw a couple that I didn't film, so I probably saw getting close to 15 deer maybe. But yeah, that's just the way it goes in late season. These bucks could be here. They could be a mile away on the neighbors, 2 miles away. But you know, I didn't cover every square inch of the property. Yeah, they could be in those places, but that's not my goal. My goal is to maximize the amount of time that I have out, not try to comb every square inch of the property. Just go hit those main good spots that I normally see those bucks in, and then I'm out. Okay, you can see I just walked through here, and now look what's here. A big old bear track. That's pretty good size. I mean, that's another paw there, but just about smaller than the size of my hand. I'm gonna say that's a 250 plus pound bear. And I don't see that many bears here in this section, but he come right out of that thick stuff. Huh. I bet them deer bumped him. I bet them deer were up in there and he come right through here. And I was only down in that bottom for like enough for that video to talk about getting my trail camera turned around. So he's close, but going away from me. That's good. Oh, and that's pretty much it. That's the end of my 2023 deer hunting season. Hope you guys liked the video. Not much going on this year with the whole crew because everybody's having kids and families and jobs and life gets busy. You know how it goes, so we just get out when we can and film when we want. So, till next season. Finishing up here with the video, and just wanted to let you guys know that got some trail camera pictures for you to see. I checked that bottom trail camera where that doe was bedded, and didn't really have that many pictures because the batteries died. But the first one that I came up to where the doe was behind it, look what was on this camera. Yeah, so he made it through the hunting seasons, and he's definitely gonna be a monster next year. So stay tuned. Hopefully we can find his sheds.